It was a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and Will Smith Landjogger was taking advantage of it. He was strolling next to the road, the safest place to be in the town of Rivendell.
If only Uncle Jack were here to enjoy it with me,
Will thought to himself. His uncle, Jackie Chan, had passed away the previous month. After the funeral, still emotional from the proceedings, he stopped by his uncle's house to grab a few of the possessions that his uncle had left for him. Among the utensils, bed knobs, and broomsticks that Uncle Jack had left for him, Will found a marvelous ring. It fit perfectly on his hand, so he decided to wear it to remind him of his uncle. Every time he looked at it, he felt proud to have been raised by such an amazing man. Will's thoughts were interrupted by loud cries nearby. He glanced up the road and immediately started to sprint in the opposite direction. In the distance, he had seen one of the most fearsome sights that could ever be seen in Middle-earth. A group of orcs was charging up the road towards him. He continued to run as fast as he could, but he had already been walking for a very long time and was very tired from it. The orcs were quickly catching up to him. He had no choice but to stand and fight as well as he could. He scanned the ground close to him and found a large stick to defend himself. As the first orc arrived close to him, he rose his makeshift weapon to strike the orc, possibly the last move he would make. The orc raised its own weapon and sneered at Will as it prepared to deliver its fatal blow. Suddenly, the orc dropped on the ground, along with all of its companions. From behind them strode a stranger that walked carefully over the bodies of his defeated opponents towards Will. The man didn't seem very threatening. He was fairly tall and had a very slim build. He wore simple robes that flowed on the ground. However, his eyes seemed to stare right through you, wise and omnipotent. He carried a large staff that was filled with intricate carvings and designs. It was a symbol of power, and Will knew that this man was far more powerful than he looked. He strode up to Will with a sense of dignity.
Would I be right in assuming that you are Mr. Landjogger?
Asked the strange man.
Indeed you are, sir,
replied Will, wary of the stranger.
I am going to get straight to the business I must attend to,
stated the man.
My name is Blandolph, and I was a friend of your dear uncle. My, my, what a man.
The man exclaimed emotionally.
He told me that if he ever should die, I should tell you about his ring. We must be brief, for this is a matter of great importance. The ring is the key to destroying the Darth Sauron that awaits outside the atmosphere of Middle-earth, eager to destroy all who come in its path. It is planning a missile attack on this planet, which will leave the planet and its population devastated forever. To destroy this killing machine, we must take the ring to a volcano that resides on the Death Sauron. Once the ring is thrown in, the Death Sauron will be destroyed. The galaxy will be safe and our enemies will be defeated forever. Are you willing to come with me to take on this mighty task?
Of course,
exclaimed Will.
I would be honored to be part of saving the galaxy.
I want to join too,
shouted someone from far in the distance. As that person drew closer, Will realized that it was his best friend, Samward Gamgee. In one word, Sam was useless. He didn't really do much to help or hinder anyone in Rivendell. He was just there. However, he was very loyal, and Will knew that he could trust Sam to accompany him on the mission.
Very well, you may come too,
murmured Blandolph.
I have a ship a few minutes away that we may take to the volcano.
They sauntered over to the ship, a small but fast vessel that could easily take them through the atmosphere. They quickly piled in and set off on their quest. As they traveled, they decided to call themselves the Three Amigos. Unfortunately, they had no idea that orcs had snuck onto the ship and sabotaged their controls previously. As a result, as Sam piloted the plane, the steering system malfunctioned and forced Sam to safely crash the ship back on the planet. After making sure that everyone was okay, the Three Amigos left the plane to find repairs. A terrifying sight met them. A pack of elves was waiting, pointing their bows at the Three Amigos. The threatening elves decided to assist the three men in their journey, for they too had experienced great hardship as a result of the Death Sauron and its evil master, Emperor Sauron. Once the repairs were made by the elves, the Three Amigos took the ship back into space. They found the Death Star on quickly and landed on its desolate surface. The Death Star on's only remarkable feature was the volcano. The rest of the planet was dirt and a small outpost. They approached the outpost with caution, unaware of the danger they were about to face. As they arrived, Sam saw a huge red button and felt an uncontrollable urge to touch it.
I wonder what this does,
Sam wondered aloud as he pushed it with his puny strength. Immediately, hordes of orcs appeared on the surface of the Death Star. The Three Amigos fought them and defeated them with immense difficulty, obtaining many wounds in the process. Just as they finished defeating the orcs, the evil Emperor Sauron appeared.
Run to the mountain and throw on the ring. You're my only hope,
shouted Blandolf as he prepared to fight Emperor Sauron. Will and Sam hesitated because they knew that Blandolf wouldn't be able to defeat the Emperor, but they knew they had to throw him in the ring. As they raced towards the volcano, they heard the fighting between the two men. As they reached their destination, they glanced back and saw that Blandolf had finally fallen, and that Emperor Sauron was flying towards them on a purple chicken named Nugget. They ran up the volcano as fast as they could, but the Emperor and his steed were faster. They reached the top of the volcano and blocked the way for Will and Sam.
You will never defeat me and my Death Star. We will take over the galaxy. There is nothing you can do to stop us.
The Emperor laughed to himself, believing that he had beaten the two friends.
Is that pizza over there?
Asked Will randomly, always thinking about his stomach.
I want some pizza. Fly to the delicious food nugget,
shouted the Emperor, desiring to feast upon the fresh cheese and bread. As the Emperor flew away on his steed, Will darted into the volcano and tossed the ring into the fire. After a minute and 23 seconds of falling, exactly, the ring landed in the lava. During that time, Sam and Will raced back to the ship and left the Death Star on very quickly. The planet itself began to shake as soon as the ring landed in the lava. With a large volcanic eruption and many tremors, the Death Star on exploded and sent shards flying everywhere into space.
Kaboom! Bam! Bam!
Will and Sam nearly crashed many times, but they managed to fly the ship back to the planet. As they stepped off of the ship, they glanced back into the atmosphere that they had just traveled through, into the place in space where the Death Star had previously been. The galaxy and Middle-earth were finally safe from evil.